Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. So in this video we are going to create a project on JavaScript that will be the collapsible or the what is the word? So the word is accordion. Okay. So what we need to do, we need to create another folder because we are going to create the project. The name is accordion for collapsible. Okay. So we can't use the slash. Accordion for so this is the project. Here in get.html. So now let's have the structure. So here what we have to do, what I have to do basically. Basically I need to code for the CSS. The CSS is short, so I will use here inline CSS. Actually it is not the inline CSS, it is the internal CSS, okay. So here let's use the what we are going to use, we are going to use the HTML. Inside of the HTML we have a div which is, we have a div. Div with the ID, the class should be the accordion, okay. So here there is another div, the class should be the panel, okay. There is a p tag and lorem with 10 bars, okay. So that is it. Actually let me do with this 20 bars. Lorem 20 watts. Okay. So this is it. Draw out V. So that is it. So what we want to do, we want to use them 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So here, what we need to do basically, we need to use for there actually the accordion is the button, I think the accordion is the button. So basically accordion is the button. So inside let me go back. So here this one should be removed. There the accordion is the button. Because when you click on the button type accordion, okay, section one, okay. So here type should be button, and what should we need to do, we need to put onClick method. Actually we don't need to use the onClick method because we will use the add event listener method, okay. So we need to give it to the ID. ID should be the class. Class should be the accordion. So here let me control alt V. So actually we need to copy this new command and need to paste 3 times. So that is it. So let me change the name. It is actually 3 and it should be 2. So once they are 3 and 2, then what we need to do actually. So now let me go back to its result. So this is the result of the previous one project. Okay, so here what is the result of this project. So here basically we have section. So first of all, what I need to do, I need to assign for the button. I need to code for the CSS of the button. So here dot class is according. Cardigan, the building should be 100% and okay, the height should be the 50, then let me check. Okay, that is it. So here, let me check what is the video. Okay, finally. When we go onto the button, then border should be none. And when we go onto the button, the pointer cursor should be the pointer. So it is the pointer and border has been none. The color, background color. Background color should be the okay. So now it is good. No, it should be the sky blue. Sky blue. Okay, that is okay. So finally, what we need to do, we need to call the padding. Padding should be the 10 pixels. Let me check if it will work. From left and right, and it should be 0 pixel from top and bottom. So for text, actually text align should be left. So now it has the left side. So this side, font size 20 pixel. And our flow hidden. So actually our flow is the padding, I think so. Okay, so what we need to do basically. Our cardigan with okay, I think we have done with the accordion. So here we have to put the hover. So by doing with the hover dot accordion hover, background color should be the black. So when we hover over the it font color should be white. So this is the font page should be the gold. So now it is looking like something better than before. So now it is done with this one. So here now it is the time for it is time to start the panel. Dot panel. Let me copy and paste. Panel class. The panel class should be what? First part overflow should be the hidden. Okay. Then it works. This place should be the none. This place so that the, now the overflow is but good. Well, I think so. Okay, let me remove this one for now. So here we need to code style for the body. The body should be actually where was I? I was styling the body. Padding should be the 0. Okay, margin should be the 0. Margin 0. So now it is looking awesome. So here, what should we need to do? So here, let's copy and paste. Control C, Control V. Control X, sorry, Control V, Control C. So here, Control V. Okay, so now what we have to do? So now we have to code for the CSS. We have to code for the JavaScript. So here, script tag. Script tag, inside of the script tag, what we need to do basically, we need to create a variable. Variable IDD tag would be equal to, or ACC accordion would be equal to document.get element by class name. Get element by class name. What is the class name? Accordion. Let me copy and paste, that will be better. Okay. So here, what we need to do here, we need to add a event listener account dot accordion dot add event listener dot add event listener. Actually, what is the code? Account dot add event listener, that is method. Add event listener. Okay. So inside of this function, inside of this, what should we do when you click onto this ID? So this ID, what should it do? It should run the function. What should it do? It should run the function. Run the function. This function. So this is the function. Inside of the function, let's create a variable I. Remove it as it is. Well, the function is not still correct. Actually, we need to add a comma. So now it is correct. So here, what we want to do basically, we have to run a loop. Okay, so variable I, we have declared a variable. So here, for loop, I think I have to run if statement. If statement. Okay, so actually, but you need to do if statement, if else. The condition is before the if statement, what I need to do, I need to create a variable panel would be equal to this dot new, this it means to say that this accordion dot new sibling, next element sibling, element sibling, next element sibling. So here, actually, if I am running the if statement, if I is equal to 0, account dot length. So length means to say that it have index I. Index account index should be the I. So if it is the I am ready, sorry. Here I am a little bit confused. Actually, this is the for loop. So, if this is the for loop, then we need to run a for loop here. For loop. Okay. So, the net index is net I is equal to. I is equal to this one. If we are going to run this for loop, what is this? Let me run the for loop by default. For loop. For loop. So this is the for loop. Inside of the for loop, actually I need to put this one inside of the for loop. Control F because one loop starts here and ends here. Control R P. So that is it. Inside of the for loop, there should be the if statement. If for loop I is equal to 0, I is less than account dot length. Account dot length. I am still wrong a little bit, so let me close if I state first because it is disturbing us much. So here if I am using the I index here, then I need to have what I need to have basically, let me close. Okay, so I need to have this statement here. Control X and in the for loop. So let me check now. It's and here and it's and here, then why it is here? I also need to declare the I variable in before the loop, that is it. So actually now we are the right. So here actually I have disturbed the code very much. So now it is looking at something better than before. So here our code starts. That even this will make it starts here. So it starts here and it's end here. So now it is okay. First of all, I need to do. So first of all, if the I index is add even this method, so link onto the function. So this is the function. When we click onto this button, that is it. It will pass the index. Okay. So here we need to pass the increment, not a decrement. So that is it with the loop. Now it is okay. follow starts here and ends here. Then where it is, so now it is very good. So now our coding structure is well and good. So in the loop there is a function. This function should call. Okay, this function should call. This function should call. So what we need to do basically, final dot next sibling. So this dot next sibling, actually the next sibling is this div. Okay, and we have a variable to play this value, div value, inside of the panel. So now I need to put the if statement, if else statement. If panel, panel dot style dot style dot display, display is equal to blocks are ready. Blocks are ready, then what should it do? So it should, what should it do? It should panel, it should null the display. Panel dot style dot display would be equal to null. Okay. Else if it is not display, as panel dot style dot display should be equal to null. So that is. So now let's go back to our project. So this is it, as it is working. So here in the side of the panel, it has the CSS padding should be the 20 pixels. Okay, now it is working well. Font size should be the 10 pixel. Font size actually 20 pixel. 25 pixel. Font weight. Font weight should be the bold. So now this is it. Actually bold is not looking bad. Bold is not looking bad. So that is it. Okay. So that is okay with the simple accordion or collapse. It is a simple accordion or collapse. So here what I need to do basically I need to put the background color. for the panel. Background color should be very light. I think this is the light. The same color I use. The sky. Light blue, light pink. So that is looking something awesome. So here we have actually done with the simple accordion or flexible. So now what we need to do? Actually we need to make the accordion of animation, accordion or the flexible animation. So here what we need to do, we need to add a new HTML index1.html. Okay, so here all the properties copy and here are the copy page. So let me run into the open live server. That's it. So here what we need to do, I need to make it to the animation. So animation I need to pass the maximum height. Maximum height should be the 0. 0 pixel or 0 pixel is the same. And the display shouldn't be the none. Because I will do it with the JavaScript, I think so. So actually I also need to add the overflow hidden. Basically it will work with just here. It will not disturb us by using that one. Transition should be the 1 second is out. This is the property of the transition. Okay. So here let's go back to our project. So basically we have done with this one. So now it is looking like the same. So now that has been hidden. Background color. What should we do with the background color? So actually it is showing the padding. It is showing us the padding. So I need to remove the padding top and bottom. So now it has been removed. Once it has been removed, then let's check the overflow. So it will disturb us. And now it is disturbing us. So let's use the overflow. Okay, because we have used the maximum height. If we will not use the maximum height, then it will not disturb us, and it is showing all of the things. So display should be none. Display should be the... So now it is not disturbing us. So actually we don't need to have the display. We must have the display. So display should also be the maximum 0. So here overflow should be hidden. So that's it. So now let's code for the JavaScript. So here inside of the JavaScript, what we need to do, we have a maximum height. Okay, panel dot style dot maximum height. Max height. If there is a max height, then what should it need to do? It should need to max height. If there is a max height, then it should do what? Max height to be none. No, it is not none. Actually it is null. it means to say that there shouldn't be the high, maximum high. Okay, in the panel, actually panel is the next element of this accordion, because we have got accordion when we click on the add event listener method. It have run the function, so we are accessing this next value inside of this accordion, that is the panel, and assign it to the variable panel. And that's all that have maximum height. If there exists, then what should it do? It should assign it to the null position, null value to the maximum height. So it means to say that the maximum height will be hidden. If it is, exists. If it is not exist here, then it should actually not display. Not display the max height should be. Max height should be, but should be, it should scroll height. It should scroll height. Scroll height. Okay, it should do scroll height. Actually, it is the property of the height in the JavaScript. Scroll height, there would be concatenation in the pixel. So now let's move back here. So when I click on this, it should need to work, but it is not working. There would be any problem. Let me check where is the problem. Actually, it is a property. Then we need from where we are going to pass this property. Actually, we need to pass this property to the panel div. Panel element. So here panel. Panel dot scroll navy scroll height. So that's it. So now let's go back to our project result. Refresh it. Now it should need to do. It should need to work. Actually still it is not working. So what is the main problem? It should be inside of the pixel style dot maximum height. Actually, the spelling problem could be here. It is scroll height. This is the problem. Scroll height. Scroll height. That is okay. So, this is the result. Refresh it. So now it is working. Actually, I add the one transition 1 second. So that is it. So actually, we need to change the color of the button. Background color of the button should be the green. Accordion background color should be the green. So now, this is it. We have done with our JavaScript. So basically, let me try to add a plus and the minus icon here. So what we will do? Here we need to add a but span with the class should be the icon. Okay. So the icon will be the should be the plus by default. So here it is the plus variant. So here it is the plus variant. So let me copy this span here and paste it there. Then paste it there. So now we have 3 plus icons here. So the ID is the icon. Here I will access icon in CSS with the class dot control V icon control V control X then dot control V. So here its size, font size should be the font size should be but font size should be the goal. No, actually for weight is goal. For size. For weight goal. So now it is good, but I need to increase the size. For size 25 pixels. 40 pixels will be better. So here the plus is big as big as it is. So what we need to do, we need to float it to the text align should be the right. Then I also need to add a padding. It shouldn't text align should be the center. Why it is not working? Because I need to put that into the p tag. Here it should be the inside of the p tag. Now it is, it should be the a dot icon. So actually it is disturbing me. Let me go back to here. Here should be the, so now it is the button a dot icon plus. Okay, no problem. Span dot icon. Span dot icon. So that's it. Actually, I want to float it to the, let me, if the text line is working, then what I need to do, I need to make it to the float. So here, in the CSS, float. Not right. So now all of them are in the, so all of them are in the left side. So if it is the text, then what should it need to do? Actually it is not the text, but break. If I put into inside of the, so let me go back here. Text align should be the right. So now they are not, because they are not text. In terms to make it to text, but then I need to put it into H1. I need to put into the H1 dot icon. When I use any of the HTML tag, it loses its position. Dot element dot in the dot element would be this one. So what can I use? What can I use? What can I use? Okay, so here. Here, H1 should be the H1. B this player should be the null. No. No. Margin 0. Padding 0. And I also need to display block display inline. Display. So still it is not. Display inline. Now we have, that is it. Now it is the text line running through. So here, text line should be the right. So here, text align. Text line should be the right. Okay, no problem. So no, right. So now it is it. And it has been floated to the right side. So no, right. Actually, what is the main problem here? I really don't know. So now we have. So now let's code for the JavaScript. If it exists, then it should be the. Then. Actually, I need to put here. Variable icon would be equal to open the get element by class name, get element by class name. Class name. Please. Icon. So this one icon. Icon dot inner HTML. Icon dot inner HTML will be icon dot inner HTML. Inner HTML will be equal to this negative. It should be changed from the to the negative. Actually, it has also. Position of the view. Position. It is disturbing. Okay, no problem. Overflow hidden. This, when I click on this one, it should be changed from this to this. that last known icon. So the last known is really the icon. It would be changed into this one. Next height icon at document of your name. This panel actually what you need to do dot element element. So it is not working basically. So this is not working basically. Why it is not working? I really don't know. Add element. So remove element in our HTML. Document get element by ID. Document get element by icon will be equal to interaction will be equal to hi. Actually it is not getting changed. Get element by ID icon. By class name, by tag name, by tag name. H1 should be changed into height. So actually this didn't work, okay, no problem. Let's move all of the code and also all of the. Okay, let's leave them as it is. Control T, D should be removed. Save. So here, also need to remove this one property. So that is it with R. So actually this is the animation, okay, accordion or flexible animation. So that's it. Thank you for watching. Allah Hafiz.